Today's review is the final. Oh, it's so sad to see the last one come out, but it's also happy to see the last one come out. Haunted Manor model kit series from the old Haunted Mansion kits. Play it again, Tom, this time. Clever naming so that we don't have to worry about angry people out there in model world. It is really cool. Polar Lights release from the folks at Round 2 Models sent it over. I will link below where you can snag this on pre-order. I've got an early copy. It is the production copy, so everything I'll be showing you will be in yours. First up, we've got a beautiful instruction booklet with this one. Yes, it is a very large kit. It is absolutely gorgeous. And this one requires a booklet because there is all kinds of action, not just one action scene, but all bunches of them. And you can see the beautiful drawings in there. So it really makes assembling this kit quite easy. Anyone could do it. You don't need a lot of model experience to work with these. These aren't like putting a car together where the fits are rough. Thicker kits go together quite easily. The entire kit is molded in glow-in-the-dark plastic. We got some excellent pieces of the organ. Nice scroll work there. We can highlight that if we wish. We got a cool-looking bat. More parts of the organ and the sides. Look at that excellent molding. All of it in glow-in-the-dark plastic, like I said. Here's our base. These are all the valves, the levers for the organ. This is where his little stool will be. So it'll be this size, and then it'll stand quite tall as well, being 1/12 scale. So that is absolutely awesome. In the box, I just wanted to show you, there are numerous loose pieces, so be careful as you unbag it. This is the back of the mummy with his chain. This is, pretty sure this is the organ player with his little suit and cravat. We got arms for the mummy. So just be careful when you open each bag, dump it out on the table gently. I can tell this is one of the actuators for some of the action in the kit. I will make them work before I put paint on. I have no guarantee it'll work after I get the paint. We got some awesome skulls with candles coming out of their heads. I'm going to decide if I want to leave some of this glow in the dark, if I want to leave all of it painted. We're going to see. We've got arms for the mummy and the organ player. I mean, all kinds of action. We got one of his feet loose in the box, so be very careful. It's all bagged up, but it is loose. We've got a large plastic plate here. Obviously, for part of the mechanism, we've got something that's going to be going in there. Two metal axles. Three rubber bands. One thick, two small. Let's switch to the other side of the table. We're nowhere near done looking at all the parts in this thing. It is a very large kit with lots of stuff. We've got the legs on our organ player. His awesome cape. I like that the cape looks to be a separate piece. We got his cool looking head with his hat. We got the back of his body. We got the collar for the cape. We got what looks like the clasp for the cape. We got some arms halves that we saw the other ones of. This one went flying off. The molding is crisp and clean, but the parts are attached with very small attachment points to make cleanup easy. Here we've got parts of his stool. We've got different skulls for displaying on the organ pipes. We've got some organ pieces here. We've got the front of the mummy. Don't have to paint eyes on that one. That'll make me happy. Only have to paint one set of eyes. We've got the other half of the organ that we saw as a loose piece. Beautiful scroll work. We've got the top, what looks like the top. We've got various construction and base pieces and side pieces. This looks like the flip-up top and the hinge for where the mummy pops out. This one, we've got even more. We've got some mechanical pieces. We've got the other three feetses, hands, more parts of the organ display. Looks like parts of the organ pipe. And speaking of organ pipe, we've got more actuation pieces. Beautiful organ work. Look at all that open molding. All in that glow-in-dark plastic. This is where those skulls mount on the top. An exquisite kit. I can't wait to start gluing it, which is what I'm going to do right now. You can see how awesome this thing can turn out. 9.5 inches tall, 6 by 5 1/4 inch base, the box says. Painted any colors you want. You got rubber bands. You got the press, the lever. Tom will hit the keys, push the button. The mummy pops out. We got all kinds of cool stuff coming up in this one. I'm going to get it glued together, and I'll be right back. 2 hours is about the extent of the assembly time, and everything goes together quite well. I'm not having any fit issues. There are going to be some seams. If you want to take the time to eliminate every single one of those clothing seams, you go right ahead and do that. I like building quicker pace, having more fun with it, not sweating the tiny little seams. I know it's a toy. I know it's a model, so I don't need to remove the seams that fool me that I think it's a real human when I take a picture. So, but if you enjoy doing that, you go ahead and do that. We'll show you as it is, built right out of the box with hardly any work done to it. We've got the pipe organ all assembled, and as you can see, we've got one of the action elements threaded through the bottom. This is that one piece of organ pipe that will hold the rubber band in place on its peg on the parts tree that I showed you when I showed you before. These bottom parts will be cut off, but I'll clamp onto those to paint. We'll be getting those painted a nice metallic color. We'll do some weathering and detailing to them, but the pipe organ pipes look lovely. And we got it. Don't forget to get your rubber band sticking out. Now, you could always attach it later and assemble that small piece in later with some super glue, but I did it all now. We'll get it all done. These three holes in the pipe organ are for the three skulls. My idea with this one is, for the first time, I'm going to leave some of the parts in glow plastic. I like the look of them on the box. I'll leave them that color, and they will be as they are. We've got our cloak, all nice on one tree. Got the collar, got the cloak itself. We can get that painted and colored up, and then attach the figure when it's time. We won't have to paint around that. The bat on the top of the organ, we can get him painted, connected to his tree. When I cut stuff off the trees, I just touch it up with a brush. It's not a problem. The keyboard on the organ assembly, that is here with all the different levers to pull for all the different sounds. That I made sure I can push in later as one piece. I can prime this, then I can hand paint everything in there and get it all done like that without having to try to fit my little fingers in there and paint brushes, and then we can just install it and super glue it in place. We got the head of Sam, a beautiful molded piece. Looks lovely. Got the hat. The only seam we have really that you can see is in this lower neck there, and that doesn't bug me. That's going to press into his body. So he looks great. Check him out. Nice little assembly on there. One of the nicer faces on the kits that they've done. Here we've got the lid to the piano and the part of the top of the piano that the mummy comes out of. Now, I can't assemble this all until the mummy is painted and all that's attached in there. So I left these on their trees. I will get them painted the color of the piano. Then I can work on the insides. Then we can super glue everything in when we're all done and get that all working and sufficient. Now we'll have this. Now these parts are just gently pushed together. No glue or anything holding them. You can see Sam's leaning back. That's not his normal position, but I just wanted you kind of get a sense of scale of the kit. We've got the beautiful skulls with their candles. I haven't decided whether I'm going to paint the skulls. I'm going to paint the candles for sure. I haven't decided whether I'm going to paint the skulls or leave them glow. But we've got those ready to go. And the chin, don't cut that nib off the chin. That locates right in the hole there and holds it in place perfectly on top of the organ. We've got Sam here. We'll take his torso off first. His arms come up and down. Make sure that they still move freely. He's got the base for his action glued inside. So the body gets glued together, the torso, and then his arms will move when we get the action working. His legs are right there. You can position the two little attachment points in his keister and his extra large hole on the bottom there. You can position it so that his feet are touching the levers at the bottom of the organ. So when you super glue him into place once he's all painted. So we'll attach it like this. We'll be able to glue his pants separately, his feet, and he'll be ready to go. You can see the seams are not very noticeable. They go together quite well. I didn't have to do a lot of cleanup to get it to push together. We've got the cushion for the seat. with part of the action. You will glue the very front of this in place. The rest of it leave free so that we can thread the rubber band through his butt, through the seat cover, into this lever to make him work when he's sitting on the stool there. We'll move it up and down, and then his body will move. We got the seat here with its side moldings glued on. That's ready to go. That just goes into position back here, and that large hole is for that lever so you can flick it. Turning this around, there's so much going on in this kit. This is the back plate that will eventually go on. Cover it up, and the mummy's lever sits here so we can reactivate it, slide it down, and hide him inside the piano again. That's why that's there. You can see how he goes together. The two metal rods are in place. Here's your actuation lever that will hold him down. So when you load him back down with that lever, he will come down and snap into place over that lever. That lever is on this side, held by a rubber band. Get it in camera. Held by a rubber band. Matches the base, you can see it. When he's got the rubber band attached to the back of his character, and it goes all the way up to where the pipe organ is up here, the pipes, that is what will yank him up and pull him out through the top of the piano. That's how that's going to work when that's all together. Now the rest of the base I have completely assembled. We're not going to attach him in here permanently yet. So we'll take those steel rods out. Don't get paint on those, or those are going to be a real bear to work. The smooth chrome works a lot better. His arms flop, his body goes back and forth as he comes out of the top of the piano, or the organ. I keep calling it a piano. The beautiful molding on that organ and the floor, I did that all together. I can paint this up in a base color, and then we'll be able to press our keys and everything inside and get that to line up and look absolutely lovely. So we've got that all together. This will be the main color of the base. I will then hand paint the base around the bottom. That won't be an issue at all. Decorate our piano, the scroll work. We can decide how we want to accent that scroll work if we choose to. But that is how that, and these are the feet of the bat, so you know exactly where to place him. That is it. That's all the parts that are in the kit. I wanted to point out one minor thing, and I do mean extremely minor, but you should know. In the instructions when you're assembling the skulls with the candles, tiny little mistake in the instructions. It's not even worth redoing the instructions or whining or complaining about it, but I'll let you know to avoid confusion. They show the indented area down and the flat area of the skull up. Simply transverse that, put this area up so it joins into the back of the candle. So that part down there should glue up into the top of the candle. That's it. Otherwise, everything else is beautiful. And people always say, you don't point all the flaws in the kit. Well, okay, so there's the flaw. Big deal. Somebody made a little boo-boo and it took 4 seconds to figure it out. So we're going to get everything into paint. It's going to take a lot of primer, a little bit of color paint, and then I will be hand painting everything. So I'll be right back. I'm getting there. I'm getting really, really close. I've just got some things gently pushed together right now. We don't really have anything hooked up. None of the rubber bands except for the mummy. We've got our rubber band in there. And we've got the rubber band in the switch at the bottom of the base so that we can hook our mummy up and get them working. Got the face toned in. Just a very light tone with those Army Painter tones. Just to give a little definition of the face, but as you see, they dry very, very softly. So we can see the face details, but it's still in the glow. I decided with this one, it's the very last of the series. I didn't make any of the pirate stuff glow. I didn't do any of that stuff. I didn't do any of the Haunted Mansions, the Haunted Manor kits in a glow. So I decided to leave a little bit of the glow on the final kit because I have no idea what's coming out next. And I didn't want to lose the chance to do some of it still in glow. So all I did was the hands, the head, the three skulls on the organ pipes, and the two skulls on top of the organ. I painted in the candles and let the candle wax drip, but the skulls I left glow. Those will mount beautifully right there and are going to look outstanding. The glow skulls will mount in the three mounts up here. Those are going to look awesome. We've got the cape. I did a very little bit of dry brushing on the character, but not a lot, just a tiny bit to accentuate detail. You can see on the hat we did it. You can see on his body. Now, none of this is glued together, so I can pull it apart in a second. We've got the candles in the skull. We've got a rubber band that still has to be threaded through Tom and out his butt and into the base so I can flick that switch and make him move a little bit. So I hope all that works with all the paint that I've used on everything. So we'll start disassembling some stuff slowly, and you can see. We've got the top of Tom here, and his arms should move, hopefully. When I flick his body, they should move a little bit, at least, on the keys. We've got his legs that go underneath. Got his socks and his shoes painted, a little bit of dry brushing. Left the gray primer as his legs. I like that look with the tuxedo pants. We got the seat, the nice big comfy. I did it in a red velvet with gold trim, very similar to the box art. I always like to go sometimes by box art, sometimes on my own. We got the base of the seat here, which on the box art they did in a wood tone. I did it in the same tone as the organ, figuring if it's going to be built in, it's going to all be the same. I left the floor gray. I did a little bit of black wash around the base and the sides to give it a little dimension. I did the brown around the bottom. I didn't go as much washing. I didn't want to weather this one up nearly as much as I do the other ones. This one I wanted to do my own way. We got the bat on there. Did a little bit of dry brushing on him. He looks awesome now. He will hold the sheet music. If you desire, in the manual, let me dig it out here. We got this page. Got to get to the end of the manual is what I need. There it is. You can slice out some sheet music and put it in his little feet there to sit up. So I might do that towards the end with a little bit of white glue or something. I might attach that. We've got the entire base and organ together. Use some gold and brass highlights. The keys came out awesome. Really proud of those. Then what I did to define the edges and stuff with the white and the black was I ran a gray wash from Tamiya inside there. Accents on the knobs to pull out for the different valves around the back. I don't have it all glued together. I just have the pipes glued in. I've got the mummy. That shiny powder you see at the bottom is a little bit of graphite. I squirted it on the tubes, and I also opened up the holes on the mummy a little bit so that he slides a lot smoother. Oh, he's locked in a position with the base there. I'll press the lever and he can come up. You see as he goes down, there's that little locking mechanism down there. So when he's pulled down by hand and that locking mechanism pops back out, that holds him against the tension of the rubber band. When that's all sealed up, we'll close the back. I spent absolutely no time worrying about the back because nobody's going to look at the back of it. We've got our hinges on top. I also opened the hole for the rubber band to go through. The organ pipes will mount on the top in their holes. We'll attach the hinge lid. I'll do a little decoration around the edge with gold on the scroll work there, and our kit will be done, and that will be it. So this is easily built in 2 days. I'm gonna get to doing that final assembly, a little bit of gluing, hooking up the last rubber bands, and we'll be right back. The final Haunted Manor model kit series in 1/12 scale through polar lights from round 2 models is all done. Let's take a look at that beauty. So easy to build. It wasn't difficult at all. Sometimes those rubber band kits will give you some fits, but this one actually, because the action isn't dependent on how the figures are painted or anything, it actually seems to work quite well. So let's make it work. We'll show you how. We've got the lever underneath his coat, so we'll snap him back and we'll locate his arms up like, oh, getting ready to play, jam out some tunes. And this lever here makes the mummy go up. So I don't know if I can work them both at the same time, but you're supposed to be able to push. He's supposed to slam forward with his hands on the keyboard, like he's playing the keyboard. And when you push this button in, the mummy's supposed to pop out of the top. I've got the sheet music just loosely laying there. I wonder if they're going to move enough to actually make that fall off. But there we go. Check it out. I didn't quite get them in sequence. I didn't push the button in far enough. But that button has to go in quite a ways to release the mummy. And then we pull him off there. And they look awesome. The mummy jumps out at him and scares the bejesus out of him. And the sheet music actually stayed in place. So let's put this thing on spin, so we can actually take a look all the way around it, show off the detail. Now I did the glow in the dark hands, skulls, and face, and then I did a little bit of a wash with a Army Painter wash to accentuate the details. So when you look at it, it's just not like a white face and hands on there. The skulls I left alone except for painting the candles on there, which I like the effect. You can really see it. We'll try to get a better effect in the closer up pictures. But the keys come out beautifully. The organ in the bass is absolutely gorgeous with that velvet seat with the gold trim, his cape over the back, his awesome looking suit and all that, his tuxedo. And then we have, of course, the nice pipe organ. You can see where that mount is for the rubber band. You can see how you slide that down. I left the back on loose. I didn't glue it on in case I need to reattach a rubber band. But that's how it all works. And it all puts together with 3 rubber bands, 2 metal rods, and the rest is glow styrene plastic. So if you want to leave it all glow, that would be easy enough to do. I can't say enough about how awesome this entire series was. Every single one of them is fun to build. This one is by far my favorite just because it's so large and it's got the big organ. It's got 2 things that move on it, and it has a lot of beautiful detail that you can work on and make look fun. I used a gold marker around the edge on the lid that we didn't have done the last time, and then you saw how I detailed everything else. So we can see if we can get them to reload. We're going to stop the presses here so I can actually work on it. If I don't get it right on camera, we get it to load in like that, and then this time I won't try to do them together. We'll do them like in a sequence, like a slow-mo, but you push all the way in and he pops out, and then he's like, whoa, and he slams his hands down. If you have all your hands free and you're not working around a camera, you can get those to work just fine. So, and if anything sticks, just remove some of the paint around the edges and you'll get it to work. Like I said, something that helps a lot is some powdered graphite. That'll get stuff to work on there for you. And the more you use it, the more it'll slicken up and get to working for you. So, as always, thanks to Round 2 Models for sending this over. I absolutely love it. I'm going to link down below where you can grab yours. You don't have to do it my way. You don't have to do it like the box. It's your model. You paint it up in the colors you like and enjoy it and have a good time doing so. So, as always, thanks for watching the workshop on this Wednesday video. I appreciate all your views, suggestions, and nice comments, and we will see all of you at the next review.